Well, now the concept name is what? Sorting. What is the meaning of sorting? Arranging the data in the increasing order or decreasing order is called sorting. I can arrange the data in increasing order or decreasing order is called sorting. Now I'll give you some examples. You should tell which is in the sorted order, right? Let us take 13, 5, 8, 10, 9. Let us take another example. 5, 8, 9, 10, 13. Let us take another example. 13, 10, 9, 8, 5. Let us take another example. 10, 13, 5, 8, 9. I have given you 4 examples. In these 4 examples, which data is sorted? This is the data 1, data 2, data 3, data 3. In these 4 examples, which is sorted? Can you please understand? 5, increase, 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 increase. Always we are increasing only. So this data is sorted and it is in increasing order. Now can you please check this example? 13 to 5, decreased. Next number also should be what? Decreased. But is this decreased? No. So the data is not sorted. Understand? Now see here. 13, decrease. Once you start decreasing, rest of the time also should go into decreasing only, right? Is this decreased? Yes. Is this decreased? Yes. Is this decreased? Yes. So the data is also sorted. The data is sorted in increasing order. The data is sorted in a decreasing order. Up arrow means increasing, down arrow means decreasing. That's how we generally represent. Now, increase. So going forward, we need to go in what? Increase. Now see. Is this increasing? No. Decreasing. So this is not sorting. I mean to say this is not arranged in the increasing order or not decreasing order, right? So this data is considered as sorted. This data is also considered as sorted. What is the meaning of sorting? Arranging the data in the increasing order or decreasing order is called sorting. Why we need to do sorting, that we will discuss later. For now, we'll try to implement some algorithm to perform sorting. Now consider the algorithm is, the algorithm is, first step, arrange all possible combinations using permutations and combinations. Using permutations and combinations. Second, pick the correct order. Pick the correct sorted order. Now programmer is interested to go for increasing way. Programmer is interested to go for increasing way. Let us take the data is 8, 10, 5. Right? What is the first step? Arrange all possible combinations using permutations and combinations. Now see, when 8 is placed in the first position, 10 can be placed in the last position, 5 can come to this position. Means what? 5, 10. What I am trying to do? I am placing 8 here and I am trying to change the permutations of 10 and 5. Similarly, I can take 10 here. I hope this is very clear. Next, what can I do? I can start comparing these elements. I can shift here, right? Fine. Next, what can I take? 10, and I can swap these two elements also, right? Next, what can I take? 5. Next, 8 to 10. Next, what can I take? 5, 10, 8. What did I do? I took every time one number out of these and remaining two numbers are I am arranging, right? So have you seen totally we got how many combinations? 6 combinations. When we have 3 numbers, we are getting how many combinations? 6 combinations. Fine. Let us take there are 4 numbers. Let us take there are 4 numbers. When there are 4 numbers, let us take I am adding 11. 11 can come here. 11, 11, 11, 11, 11. Means what? 6 combinations. Again, this 11 can be coming here. So now every number, second number will be 11. Every number, second number will be 11. So again, 6 combinations. Previous 6 combinations, now 6 combinations, 12 combinations. Again, 11 can come here. Means what? 11 is in the third place, right? Again, now total 18 combinations. Again, 11 come here. Then that is what? 24 combinations. Totally, we are having 4 numbers. We are going to get 24 combinations. Have you understand the relation between 3 and 6, 4 and 24? Did you get any relation? Yes. What you are expecting is correct only. So 3 numbers means 6 combinations, that is nothing but 3 factorial. 4 numbers means 24 numbers, that is 24 combinations, that is nothing but 4 factorial. So whenever you are having n numbers, we will get how many combinations? N combinations. We will get how many combinations? N factorial combinations. We are getting what? N factorial combinations. Now listen carefully. First step, time taken is n factorial. Completed. Now, When there are n factorial numbers, I want to compare every number at least once. I want to compare every number at least once in every data, right? So for that also we require how much time? N factorial. See, when the range is n factorial, you need to repeat n factorial times, and n every number should be repeated n times. Means what? This will take what? N. See, this number should be repeated to check which is in the increasing order. To go like this, we require what? N. Next, same thing should be done for this number also. Same thing should be done. Like that, we have how many numbers? 24 numbers. When the value of N is 4, 24 series are there. When 24 series are there, I need to check which is in the correct order, right? Pick the correct sorted order. So, what I need to do? N factorial times, I need to go to visit all 24 series. Every series I need to again visit all the elements. That is the reason. What will be the total time complexity? N factorial plus N factorial plus N. That will be what? 2N factorial plus N. Might be 2N factorial plus N can be considered as what? Big O of N factorial. Can you please understand what is the algorithm we are discussing? Arrange all possible combinations and pick the correct sorted order. So for that, the time complexity is what? O of N factorial. One beautiful thing about the algorithm is we never wrote the code. We just wrote the code in the English only. What is algorithm? Writing the code in the form of English. Writing the program step by step in the form of English is called an algorithm, right? Fine. Now, if there is any other algorithm which will take less time when compared to O of N factorial, I will not write code for this. Understand, right? And we have so many other algorithms where it will take less time. That we know. Now we are going to prove. So, for that, we are not writing code. I mean to say, why we are not writing code? Because there are some other algorithms which will take less time. Okay, fine. Well, now we are going to see algorithm 2. Now what we are going to see? Algorithm 2. What algorithm 2 is telling is compare adjacent elements. What is algorithm 2 is telling? Compare adjacent elements. When I say adjacent elements, if first element is greater than second element, if first element is greater than second element, then swap. I hope this is very clear. Next thought point is, repeat the process for every element in an array. Every element in an array. Okay, this is what they are telling. Our target is, I want to arrange the data in an increasing order. Target is very clear. I want to arrange the data in increasing order. Let us take an array which is exactly reverse. Okay, fine. Let us take 25, 15, 10, 5, 0. These are the series of numbers we are having. How many elements are there in the array? 5. Remember this. Now, what they are telling? Compare adjacent elements. These two are adjacent like that. Next, what are they telling? If first element is greater than second element, try to understand, swap. 25 is greater than 15, yes, so swap. Fine. Next, what should I do? Repeat the process for every element, right? Now, 25 is greater than 10, yes, so 15, 10, 25, next what? 5, 0. Next what? 15, 10 is here only. 25 will come here, 0. Next what? 15, 10, 5, 0, 25. So what I did? I compared 25 with 15 and later 25 with 10 and later 25 with 5, later 25 with 0, right? Now, first pass completed. This is the first pass. When I completed the first pass, what did we notice? First maximum is sitting in the correct position, right? Whenever I say so data is a sorted order, first maximum should be in the last position, correct? In the future, whenever I want to do same process, I should not consider that element. Why? Because already it is in the sorted. Now, up to here completed, don't focus on 25. Next, what should I do? 15 with 10, right? So what will happen here? 15, 5, 0. Next, what? 15 with 5? Next what? 15 with 0. What is here? 25 is here, 25 is here, 25 is here. Have you noticed second maximum also coming in the same thing? This is what? Second pass. Now same thing we need to do third pass also, right? Now I need to focus only on these elements. I hope this is very clear. 10 combined with 5. So 5 will come here, 10 will come here, 0 will come. It will come as it is. Don't worry about that, right? Next 10 should be combined with 0. 5 will come, 0 will come, 10 will come. Next what should I do? This is completed. No, not completed, right? So what happened here? Can you please understand? Second, third maximum also coming in the correct position. Third maximum also coming in the correct position. This is third pass. What is here? 15 is here, 25 is here. 15 is here, 25 is here. Now up to here I don't want to disturb. Up to here I don't want to disturb means these numbers will come. Now 5 is compared with 0. So what happens here? 0 will come, 5 will come. Right? This is the fourth pass. So this is 10, 15, 25. Have you noticed the data is in the sorted order? Have you noticed the data is in the sorted order, right? Let me explain you again. Compare adjacent element. Compare adjacent element. If a first element is greater than second element, then swap. 25 is greater than 15, swap. Swap. Again, swap. Again, swap. That is how we did, right? Now we'll see the algorithm time complexity, right? Now see, for the first pass, how many comparisons we made? 1 comparison, 2 comparison, 3 comparison, 4 comparison. That is how 25 came here, right? Next, try to understand. 4 comparisons. Next, how many swaps I did? First, this is swapped. Next, this is swapped. Next, this is swapped. Next, this is also swapped, right? Total, how many swaps? 4 swaps. Remember this, right? Now, I am talking about what? Comparisons. Now, I am talking about what? Swaps. Fine. Listen carefully. First time, how many comparisons? 4. How many swaps? 4. Second time, how many comparisons? 1, 2, 3, right? First comparison, second comparison, third comparison. This is not compared. Understand why? 25 is already in the correct position. 3 comparisons, 3 swaps. Next time, 1 comparison, 2 comparisons. Because up to here, data is clear. Next time, 1 comparison. 1 swap. Can you please tell total number of comparisons? Total number of comparisons. How many? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, right? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1 also you can write. Now, total number of swaps. How many? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. Try to remember. Here, what is the value of number of elements? Number of elements are 5. Number of elements are 5. Let us assume number of elements are n only. Number of elements are n only. If you can consider, if number of elements are n only, when n value is 5, I reach up to 4. When n value is n, I need to reach up to what? N minus 1. So, we need to do 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus up to n minus 1 comparisons. I need to do how many comparisons? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus up to n minus 1 comparisons. Similarly, how many swaps? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus n minus 1 swaps. This is at maximum, right? For example, if there is any data, something is not already, if 25 is in the correct position, then not behind that we will go, right? Behind that we will not go. Right. What is the value of first n natural numbers? First n natural numbers will be what? N into n plus 1 by 2. But here, it is not first n natural numbers. It is first n minus 1 natural numbers. Means, n plus I need to substitute n minus 1. Means, what will you get? N minus 1. I substitute n minus 1. Here also n minus 1 into n by 2. This is for what? Number of comparisons. Next, what I need to do? Plus n minus 1 into n by 2. This is for what? Number of swaps. Number of swaps. I hope this is clear, right? So what is the total value? N minus 1 into n. Because 3 by 2 plus 3 by 2 will be 3 only, right? By 2 will be cancelled. Next, what is the total time? N square minus n. What is the dominating term? N square. So the time complexity of this algorithm is O of n square, right? And the comparing adjacent elements and swapping the first element with the second element, that algorithm is called a bubble sort. So, the time taken for the bubble sort is what? O of n square. Previous algorithm was taking how much time? O of n factorial. If you can understand, O of n square is way better than n factorial. That is the reason Now I need to write the code for this. Have you noticed? Till this time I never write code, right? First, what will I take? I'll take algorithm 1, I will estimate the time complexity. I will take algorithm 2, I will estimate the time complexity. Which algorithm is giving you the less time complexity? We need to write code, right? Because before writing the code only, we need to estimate the time complexity. Fine. Well, what is the time complexity of bubble sort? O of n square. We are ready to write the code, right? Before writing the code, we'll try to understand how do we crack the code, right? See here. Let us take all these elements are stored in an array. All these elements are stored in an array. And we are assuming the index will start with 0, right? Fine. So, first element is started with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 0 is compared with 1. 1 is compared with 2. 2 is compared with 3. 3 is compared with 4, right? See here, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 0. That's how we, 3, 4. That's how we compare. So, what are the comparisons I need to do? 0 should be compared with 1. 0, 1 should be compared with 2. 2 should be compared with 3. 3 should be compared with 4. So, for the first time, I need to do 4 comparisons. Yes. We are able to do 4 comparisons. When comparing, I need to do swap also. Fine. That is clear. Second time also what? I should not consider this person. 0 with 1, 1 with 2, 2 with 3 only I need to do, right? So, 0 should be compared with 1, 1 should be compared with 2, 2 should be compared with 3. Next time what should I do? Here only, right? 0, 1, 1, 2 only I need to do. 0, 1, 1, 2 I need to do. I hope this is clear. Next time what should I do? 0 with 1. First time how many comparisons? 4 comparisons. Next time how many comparisons? 3 comparisons. Next time 2 comparisons. Next time 1 comparison. Now, just to try to understand, this is my I. If this is I, this will be I plus 1. This is I. If this is I, this will be I plus 1. This is I. Definitely I plus 1. I plus 1. Means, for the first time, I should start from where 0, go up to where 3. Remember that. Second time, I should start from where 0, go up to where 2. Third time, I should start from where 0, go up to where 1. Fourth time, I should start from where 0, go up to where 0. This is what the target we are having. Now, first time, loop should repeat 4 times, next time loop should repeat 3 times, next time 2 times, next time 1 time. I hope this is clear. Now, I want to write a loop 1 time, 2 times, 3 times, 4 times. Means what? I need to write 4 loops. Instead of writing 4 loops, I can write nested loops. Outer loop will repeat 4 times. Using 4 times outer loop, I am able to process this now. Okay, fine. Well, now we'll write the code for this. How do you write here? Void bubble sort int arr array comma int n. N is the number of elements. In our example, I considered n value 5. So, first time outer loop should repeat how many times? Every time outer loop should repeat how many times? 4 times. So, how do we write here? Let us take int k, i. K is for outer loop, I is for inner loop, right? So, how do I do this here? For k is equal to 0, k less than n, k is equal to k plus 1. Can you please understand? N value is what? 5. So, 0 less than 5, true. 1 less than 5, true. 2 less than 5, true. 3 less than 5, true. 4 less than 5 is also true. Means outer loop is repeating 5 times, but I want to repeat how many times? 4 times. That is the reason what should I do? Minus 1. This is very important, right? Fine. Now I am able to understand outer loop will repeat 4 times. What is the value of k? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? So 0 less than 4 true, 1 less than 4 true, 2 less than 4 true, 3 less than 4 true, 4 less than 4 is false. Means this is the false condition. I hope this is very clear. Now, what is the value of n? 5. I hope this is clear, right? Now, first time I need to get what? 3. Here also n value 5. Every time n value 5 only, right? Fine. Focus on this because this is false. I don't really care. Now 5 minus 0. What is the value of 5 minus 0? 5, 5 minus 1, 4, 5 minus 2, 3, 5 minus 3, 2. But the requirement is what? 3, 2, 1, 0. So what can you do? Try to understand. N minus k minus 1 means what? Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. What is the value? 4, 3, 2, 1. So first time, loop will repeat 4 times, next time 3 times, next time 2 times, next time 1 time. That's what we got right. 4 times, 3 times, 2 times, 1 time. That's what we need to write. How do I write it? It's here. For j is equal to g, I write I is equal to 0, I less than n minus k minus 1. I less than n minus k minus 1. Next, what can I write here? Just understand. I plus plus. Now, see, first time k value is 0. 5 minus 0, how much? 5. 5 minus 1, 4. Means 0 less than 4, 1 less than 4, 2 less than 4, 3 less than 4 is true. I hope this is clear. 4 less than 4 is false. Means I value started from 0, went to 1, went to 2, went to 3, right? I also want 0 to 3 only, right? Now what should I do? If a of I is greater than a of I plus 1, that's what we discussed here, right? If I value is 0, I plus 1 value will be 1. Now what should I do? Swap. If you consider a, you also consider a, right? Anything one standard name you consider. Address of a of I comma address of a of I plus 1. Completed. Function is here. Outer for loop, inner for loop, if. And we assume there is a swap function. Now we will write main functions here. Void main. Int arr. Let us take 35, 25, 15, 10, 5. How many elements? 5 elements. Next, what will I do? Bubble sort of. ARR is array name. Base address will be pointed by A. Next, N value is 5. I hope this is clear. Now we need to validate the code here anyway. Okay, fine. Well, now I wrote swap function also for you and I just made the code neat. Now I am calling bubble sort. Now A will contain the base address, N value is 5. Fine. Now what is the value of K? 0. K value is 0. Remember, 0 less than 4. See, 5 minus 1 is 4. Every time I will not calculate N minus 1 because it's a fixed value 4. True. Come inside. Now we created I value with what? 0. N value is 5, K value is 0, 1. 5 minus 0, 5 minus 1, 4. I hope this is clear, right? Fine. Next, what I am trying to do, I value 0. 0 is compared with 0 plus 1. Means what? Value at 0 index is compared with value with the first index. 35, 25, swap. Right? True, no? 35 greater than 25, call to swap. Here we already know the swap function, right? So what will I do? Swap. What happens here? 25 is here, 35 is here. End of the loop, come here, I plus plus. I value is what? 1. 1 less than 4, true. Come here, 1 is compared with 2. 1 is means what? Indexes. The value at 1 index is compared with the value at 2 index. 35 is greater than 15, true. True means what should I do? Swap. End of the loop, come here, I plus plus. I value will become how much? 2. 2 less than 4, true. Come here, compare. 35 with 10. End of the loop, I plus plus. I value will be what? 3. 3 less than 4, true. A of 3 is compared with A of 4. A of 3, 35, A of 4, true. Swap. Now, 0 is compared with 1, 1 is compared with 2, 2 is compared with 3, 3 is compared with 4, right? So, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4 are compared and every time also I swapped. Every time I swapped, remember that. Now, come here, I value will be 4. 4 less than 4 false. End of the loop, k is equal to k plus 1, k value is 1. 1 less than 4 true. Come here, again I value is reinitialized to 0. I value is reinitialized to 0. Fine. Next, what should I do? N value 5. 5 minus 1, 4. 4 minus 1, 3. Now remember the n minus k minus 1 value is 3, right? Remember that. 0 less than 3, true. Come inside, a of 0 is compared with a of 1. 25 is compared with 15. Next step, I value should be incremented. Okay. 1 less than 3, true. Come here, 1 is compared with 2. Value at 1 index is compared with 2 index. End of the loop, come here, I is equal to I plus 1, I value will be 2. Right? 2 is also less than 3, true. Value at 2, value at 3 are compared. True means swap. 25 and 15. Next what? I value will be 3. 3 less than 3, false. Means what? We started comparing with 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3. Right? 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3. That's what we compared. Next what? End of the loop. 3 less than 3, false. Come out. K value will be updated to 2. 2 less than 4, true. 5 minus 3, 2. 2 minus 1. 5 minus 2, 3. 3 minus 1, 2. I hope this is clear, right? Fine. Now again, I value is reinitialized to 0. 0 less than 2 is true. 0 is compared with 1. 0 is compared with 1. True means swap. Fine. Next what? I plus plus. I value is how much? 1. 1 less than 2 also true. Come here. 1 and 2 are swapped. 15 and 5 are also swapped. I value will become 2. I value will become 2. 2 less than 2 is false. Come out. So what are compared here? Can you please understand? 0 is compared with 1. 1 is compared with 2. 25 and 35 not involved in the comparison. Right? Fine. Next what should I do? Can you please understand? False. No. Come here. K is equal to K plus 1. K value is 3. 3 less than 4. True. K value is 3. 5 minus 3 is 5 minus 3 is 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. 0 less than 1 is true because I value is reinitialized to 0. 0 less than 1 is true. Come here, 0 is compared with 1. 0 is compared with 1. Next what? I value will be updated to 1. 1 less than 1 is false. Come out. Next k value is updated to 4. 4 less than 4 is also false. So what we compared here? 0 is compared with 1. I hope this is very clear, right? So sometimes have you noticed this type of questions are asked in the patterns. Do you notice this? So the interest behind this pattern is not about the pattern. The internal intention is to use bubble sort. Okay. So previously here we were writing print logic. Now we are writing what here? If and swap logic, right? Fine. So first time this loop repeated 4 times. This loop repeated how many times? 4 times. Next, this is 4. This is also what? 3. This is 4. This is 2. This is 4. This is 1. This is 4. This is 0. If you can take total, already we discussed it, it will become what? O of n square, right? Fine. So the time complexity will be what? O of n square. Fine. And space complexity. In this program, I used, what are the extra variables I used? One variable is A, N, K, I and swap variable, right? These are all the extra variables I used. I hope this is clear. Based on the length of the input, extra variables are not varying. So space complexity will be what? O of 1. This is a time complexity. I hope this is clear. Next, I would like to tell one more important point for you people, just to try to remember this, okay? Fine. Now, I am going to tell one concept called naming convention, okay? Fine. What are the type of the identifier we use? Variables. It's an identifier. Function name. Next, case label. Next what? Structure or class name. Next, symbolic constants. All variable names should be written in the small case. Let us take simple example. N is the number of elements. If you want to write a total salary, how do you write? Tot underscore salary. I hope this is very clear, right? If I want to write left size, how do you write left underscore size? What is the purpose? All variables should be written in the small case and you can use underscore. Next, function name. How should you write function name is a camel case. What is that one? Camel case. What is the meaning of camel case? I will tell. Let us take the function is test. Simply I can write test. If the function name contains more than one word, first word small, second word onwards, so first letter is capital. Right? Let us take bubble sort. Bubble sort. First word small, from second word onwards, first letter is capital. Next, let us take do more stuff. How do you write? Do more stuff. This is what? Function name. Next, case label. Case label and variable, we follow same rules because they are all same type of identifiers. Next, structure. Structure name always capitalize first letter of each word. Capitalize first letter of each word. Let us take employee. Let us take, I want to write employee data. How do you write? EMP data. Let us take, I want to write a class name called linked list. How do you write? Linked list. Next, constants. All constants should be written in the capital. Let us take max. If I want to represent integer max, how do you represent int underscore max? Let us check, I want to represent pi. How do you represent pi? Pi. So these things are symbolic constants. Symbolic constants we can achieve using what? Hash define or enum, right? Fine. So this is a standard practice we use in all programming languages. Understand? Whether you go to C or you go to C++ or you go to Java, you go to Python, any language you take, this is a standard practice. Don't ask me that if I don't use this, what happens? Nothing will happen. Nothing will happen, strictly speaking. But try to understand, it's a good programming practice. Why? If I can see some x, x is what I really don't know. It's a function or a constant or a variable or identifier, I don't know. By seeing the name, I can easily tell it's a variable. Yes, sir? Next, let us take, I'm writing this like this. Sal, cal, c. By seeing this, I can tell this is a function. Why? Because first word is small, from second word onwards, first letter is capital. Sal calculation. That's what I mean, right? And going forward, try to understand. I am using KI, no problem. But you people start implementing this way. This you can write as out underscore ITR. Means it's a output iterator. This one, how can you write? In underscore ITR means what? This is a inner loop iterator, right? So it's a good programming practice. Might be the length of the variable name is big, readability is also good, right? See here. See, if you write K, what is K? We really don't know. But if you write out underscore ITR, okay, it's an output iterator. If you can write in ITR, okay, it is inner loop iterator. So it is always meaningful when you write like this. If instead of bubble sort, simply if you're writing something like, let us take test. What test will do? We really don't know. Right? So it's always a good programming practice you write. Instead of ARR, if you write M, what is M? We really don't know, right? So it's a good programming practice to write what name like this. And it's an integer array. It's a good programming practice to start something with what I. Means what? I is an integer array. If you want to start a float array, then how can you write FARR, right?